All right, welcome to my first video for my website about my tour through Europe. I promise you video, and we are going to start off with the Grand Palace of Versailles outside of Paris, France. This palace was created by Louis XIV in the 17th century for two reasons. First, he wanted an escape from Paris as a way to enjoy being king and get out of the city and, well, just enjoy the lavishness that his wealth created. Secondly, he wanted a place for the nobles to come. Because the nobles were partying, having fun outside of Paris, here, drinking, enjoying themselves. They weren't going to rebel against his rule, and there was a way to keep tabs on them back. So today we're going to go through the palace, explore all the rooms and the magnificent gardens, and see what Louis created. All right, let's start. Okay, we are in the Hercules Room. This room was built for Louis' daughter's wedding reception, based around this painting right here. It was Louis' favorite, and it was designed by Paolo Veronese, a Venetian painter. And this whole room is built in Baroque style. And the name gets the room from the painting of Hercules up here. Okay, we're in the throne room now, and as you can see, it's very, very crowded in the Palace of Versailles. This room was used for ceremony and pomp, and the painting back over here was painted when Louis was 63 years old, and shows him in a dancer's pose because he really liked to dance. And in fact, during parties and celebrations, they would come and dance around the throne. The throne, which was over here but destroyed in the Revolution, was covered in a curtain that had three rings above it. Okay, our tour through Versailles continues. We are now in the Hall of Mirrors. Seeing the crowd is still really, really thick. But the Hall of Mirrors really shows the opulence that was Louis' court. This is where he had all the big parties and all the festivities that Versailles became so famous for around the world. There are 17 mirrors that reflect 17 windows, 24 golden lace chandeliers, 7 busts of Roman emperors, and the walls are covered with pictures of Louis' military campaigns. In the center, he's playing cards, he's a big gambler, and he is adorned by cupids, and it's meant to highlight his divine status. They were taking the throne from the throne room and bring it here and party all around Louis. And continuing on is the King's Chamber and the Queen's Chamber, where once the party ended here, the party continued late night there. And that is where we are going now. Okay, we're now in the gardens of Versailles. These gardens were Louis' pride and joy. As a real Renaissance man, he loved nature, and this was his way of showing it off. Throughout the gardens, you'll see motifs to Apollo. Apollo was the sun god, and Louis was the sun king, so it was just one more way to emphasize that. Throughout here, Louis would take VIPs, nobles would play, they'd all relax. The party from inside the palace continued out here. And as Versailles got crazier and busier, Louis retreated more and more into the gardens until he even created a smaller palace at the far end where he escaped the madness that was Versailles. This is Marie Antoinette's Hamlet. She created this Hamlet because she had an idealized version of peasant life and wanted to create a working village. She produced food, meat, dairy, bread, all of it was made here, and it ended up on her plate. She had plays here, she had workers, she supervised them. This was her way of remembering Austria and the simple life there. All right, and that was Versailles. I hope you enjoyed our day here as much as I did, because it is a beautiful place, and if you haven't been here, I hope you come. And until next time.